Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for today. So finally they came, the first Android 16 custom ROM arrived. After release of stable Android 16 by Google, custom ROM world got insanely active to release their first Android 16 builds. Soon we will get Android 16 based Revolution X and other custom ROM release. But before that we got new Voltage OS 5.0, which is the first Android 16 based custom ROM. But before release of their custom ROM version, they made available new Android 16 based custom GSI, which was ported by developer Papacu for all Android devices. This GSI ROM should boot on any device, especially devices running with kernel version 5.4+. Please check icard video for detailed flashing of this GSI ROM. Today in this video, we are going to review like about device details, what's working in this initial build, which Android 16 features are available, and at the end we have shown all bugs and missing features of this GSI build. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. We booted the GSI on our OnePlus 9RT. Let's first check out about device details of new Android 16 based Voltage OS. So first time we got Android 16 ROM with new Android 16 Easter egg, which has mini spaceship Easter egg game with autopilot mode. This Voltage OS 5.0 version is unofficially ported GSI build by the developer Papacu, a cut dose off. Security patches are of latest June 2025. Kernel version will remain same like your stock primary ROM, and the kernel security is surprisingly enforcing for this ROM. Build date of this ROM is of 16 June 2025. This ROM is based on Android 16 stable QPR2 version BPA2 25060501A2 source codes. The first question everyone will ask, does everything works in this ROM? Their answer is yes. Most essential features like Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi hotspot, GPS locations, NFC, always on display, incoming and outgoing calls are working well. In my device, most of the banking and payment applications are also working. Even WhatsApp, Snapchat like chatting applications also working. Essential sensors are also working. I tested them using sensor and device info application. But there are also some major bugs and missing features in this build, which I discussed at the end of this video, so don't miss that timeline. Now we'll review all working Android 16 features of this build. This ROM have Material U Expressive 3 design for some settings. It's fully implemented for QS panel. Here you can find the new brightness slider look with new QS panel tiles. They have new on-off toggles and expanded view animations. New background blur animation and effects are available while accessing the QS and notification panel. ROM have new Android 16 setting panel with large rounded and colored setting icons. App setting menu have this new card-like Material U color menu. In status bar, we got this new Android 16 battery icon, which resembles with iOS style battery icon. Notifications on lock screen have new card look with Material U colors. On-off toggles of all the settings have this new Android 16 switch look. Except these Material U Express with 3 design changes, other changes are missing that I will show you in bug section. In terms of Android 16 feature, this ROM got new regional preferences option in the system and under language and region setting, which offers you to switch your default temperature, measurement system and even the first working day as per your region. You have to just select the region and everything will change according to your region. Even you can customize them further. In gesture setting, we got the new double press power button customizations, which offers you to quickly open camera application, or either you can use default Google Wallet application. In recent panel, new Android 16 added new close and select shortcuts, and both are available and working in this build. But there is a small bug of selection menu in this ROM. Sometimes it didn't allow you to select text or images from distance panel. On home screen, long press menu, new app list feature is available, which helps you to quickly open app drawer. But I think it's a useless feature when you can easily access app drawer by swiping up on home screen. These are all new features and expressive design look of Android 16 this ROM offers. But there are some major bugs. Like this build can't able to bypass 3 basic, TYs and strong entity checks. Even Play Protect is uncertified. But I don't know how most of banking and payment applications like Axis, PhonePe are working. Even all the chatting applications like Snapchat, WhatsApp are also working. This has maybe happened because of locked bootloader spoofing feature, but I can't guarantee all devices will have this working. Google Circle to search is working, but unfortunately I can't able to access Google Gemini. No swipe edge gesture and long press power button shortcut opens Google Gemini, but you can download this from Play Store and can use Google Assistant manually. No fingerprint and face unlock are working for me in this ROM, so you need to use only password or pattern lock for safety. Bluetooth is also not working, it didn't turn on and force close the Bluetooth. Next, dark mode caused some visibility issues for QS panel menu, but it was good anywhere in system except the QS panel. LTE network and internet working great, but whenever you make the call, it switches back to 2G calling. This is a known bug for most of JSI ROMs I use till the date. New expressive 3 design is not available for volume panels and some other parts of user interface in this system. This is all about for this new JSI build. Soon team will release their custom ROM for all officially supported devices. Maybe custom ROM will not have most of these issues because of dedicated support. JSI build will also get some updates which may solve these issues, but still it's a great opportunity for old devices running above Android 11 to try new Android 16 on their aged devices. This is all about for today guys, hope you liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming review and installation tutorial of Android 16 build for all devices. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.